for Neal. 4 seconds to go. Neal in the corner, spins to the forehand, the shot. Kunitz to Crosby. I don't think it's going to count. Crosby scores, but I believe the green light was on. They will look at this. They have the clock isolated, and Toronto has a mechanism set up specifically for this purpose. Let's see if we're going to overtime or if the Bruins have won by the skin of their teeth.
Well, it gives you an idea just how quickly things can turn. There's the clock in the left corner.
That counts.
Puck across the goal line before time expires. It looked like the Bruins were going to put this game away in regulation. Quick turnaround shot by Neal is knocked out by Kunitz. Kunitz gets to it. Nobody picks up Crosby off that far post.
0.2 seconds to go. And a 6-on-5 goal for Sidney Crosby. And you know what? If you believe in the hockey gods, maybe that's fitting for Sidney Crosby to be able to pot that goal, because it was his inadvertent deflection that deflected the puck up and over Marc-Andre Fleury to put the Bruins ahead. So now we go to OT.
Now the Bruins have done a terrific job to that final 3 or 4 seconds by protecting their zone, by making plays, by continuing to get the puck into the neutral zone, doing everything that they wanted to do defensively, and then Neal just throwing that puck in the direction of Rask.
Well, this is why the NHL has the mechanism set up with the clock in isolation and affected into the screen.
You just like to see the